So on our latest version of BetAngel, BetAngel version 151, we've modified the way that you can manipulate bets on the ladder in terms of cancelling your bets. Why is this important? Well, you're about to find out in a second what is interesting about this and what we've changed and why we've changed it that way. So to understand where we're coming from, let's go back, let's rewind a bit to look at how unmatched bets are handled on the ladder at the moment. So what we can do is we can go in, I can place some bets around the market a bit, and you can see that we've got bets stacked up on either side of the market here. Now you'll notice I'm in practice mode. It's useful to be in practice mode when you're playing with new features while you familiarize yourself with them, because you don't really want to be going live with thousands of pounds and then go, oh, I'm not sure what I'm doing. So yeah, use practice mode while you're learning new features. But you can see I put orders in on both sides of the market. And then if I want to, I can just cancel these orders. And if I want to put some more orders in over here, I can, and then I can cancel it, or I can drag and drop the orders up and down the ladder. So you can see, just move that one up here, move that to there, add another one, cancel that one, add another one on top of it, move that. You can see it's very easy to place bets, cancel them, and move them around the ladder quite easily. So what have we changed? So if we go into the settings for BetAngel, go to the unmatched bets area, when you first fire it up, you'll see this, so you just need to go along to the unmatched bets area within the ladder settings, and then you can actually change all of the way. Look at the way, the mysterious way I'm moving my hands. You can change the way that BetAngel reacts when you click on this particular area of the ladder. So the white areas on here are actually where all of your unmatched bets will be, where you can manipulate and change, modify all of your unmatched bets. So as you can see, click over here and there's your unmatched bet, and then you can do with it whatever you wish. So if you want to actually change that, you can see here it's a single left click, basically cancel all bets at the price. So if I click with a single left click, they vanish. However, what we've done now is you can actually do a single left click, a double left click, a single right click, or a double right click. So you can actually use both mouse buttons to perform different actions on your unmatched bets. So if we go into here, and we could say do nothing, but obviously that's a bit pointless. We want it to do something. But you can see here, cancel the most recent bet at price. Now, we've got in here, cancel the most recent bet at price and cancel the oldest bet. Now, if you're placing orders in the market and those orders have not been matched, then basically as the very first order, say you place five orders in the market. Okay, the very first order goes in when you first join the market, and then over time you add a few more orders into the market. Now, order number one that you placed when you first joined the market is gradually going to be moving nearer and nearer and nearer the front of the queue if you're holding the position in the market on that basis. So basically, the longer a position is in the market, the more chance it has of getting matched. That's the general rule of thumb. So if I do here cancel the most recent bet at this price, what that is saying is we're going to stack up our bets and the oldest one in the market is going to remain in the market, but it cancels the newest one. So basically, every time we cancel the newest order in the market, they bump down effectively until we get to the very last order that we had in the market. But the oldest order that you have in the market will remain there and gradually creeping towards the front of the queue if you do it in this way. And the reason that you may want to do that, I'll demonstrate it for you, is we'll put that capability into the market. And if I just move up the unmatched bets area, you'll see how this works. So I'm going to put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But can you see there's a bet reference ID down here? Now the bet reference ID in practice mode, you can see is a sort of a fake one. But if you're trading this for real live, you'll actually get a bet reference ID echoed back from Betfair. And the increment on that tells you how old your positions are. So you can see bet reference 54 is the newest. Bet 55 is older than that, and then it goes all the way up to, I've got this the wrong way around. Bet reference 54 is the oldest, and this is the newest. So can you see the one with the lowest bet reference is the oldest in the market? So you can sort by this. So if I sort by bet reference ID, Can you see the newest one, 58, is the one that we placed most recently, and 54 is the oldest one. So if we set up the ladder to cancel the most recent bet at price, if I click on the unmatched bets area now, watch what happens. Can you see it cancelled 58, 57, 56, and it's cancelling the newest orders that we've got in the market, the ones that are furthest at the back of the order queue, and it's holding the oldest ones that are nearest the front of the order queue at the front. That's why you probably want to do it. Now, there may be situations where you want to do that the other way around, depending upon what you're trying to achieve in the market, in which case you can actually say cancel oldest bet at the current price. Now, I'm going to set it up so we do the most recent bet at the current price, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up double left click as cancel or bet. So can you see we've still got the old way of cancelling positions in the market, but we also have the new way as well. So I'm just going to go back up here again. These are our old bets. If I cancel, I'm going to add a couple more in there. There you go. We've thrown a couple more orders into the market. Now, if I click once on the unmatched bet area, it cancels the oldest one. But if I double click, boom, they've all gone. Or I should say, boom, they've all gone. So can you see that you can actually mix and match the functionality of the unmatched area, depending upon what you want to do? And if you don't want to get confused, or you don't trust yourself to go click, 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 you can always do one on the left mouse button and one on the right hand mouse button. So you can see here, single right click, double right click. You could always do single right click, cancel all bets in the market. On the double left click, we'll say do nothing. So this way, excuse me, I can put some orders into the market, and then with a single right click, a single right click, I can cancel the lot. So one click of the left mouse cancels the most recent order, and a right click cancels them all. So the reason that we put this in is it allows you to manage your positions a little bit better, but also gives you more flexibility in terms of the way that the unmatched bet area or the unmatched bet column on the ladder behaves. So yeah, have a play with that. There are some other features on here, but what I'm going to do is cover those in a separate video so you can watch all the videos in individual chunks. But yeah, if you want to carefully manage your unmatched bet positions using a single click of the mouse, that's how you do it in version 151.